Welcome students, myself Akshay Kumar Srivastav, I am your computer teacher and this is my new video of class 6 and its chapter is chapter 6, giving life to the presentation. So today's topics are adding slide transition, that is given on your book page number 63, and the adding sound to a transition, varying transition speed, advance the slides, slideshow tab option, that is given on your book page number 64 and 65. So we start adding slide transition. The special effect with which a slide is introduced in a presentation during a slideshow is called the slide transition effect. What is that? The special effect with which a slide is introduced in a presentation during a slideshow is called the slide transition effect. The steps to add a slide transition effects are as follows. Click on the slide to which you want to apply the transition effect. Second, click on the transitions tab. In the transition to this slide group, you can see a number of transition effects. Click on more button to see all effects. Third, select a transition effect that you want to apply to the current slide. You can remove a transition effect applied to a slide by selecting the none button in the transition group. So how we can insert transition? Then first you open your presentation. I will already open the Microsoft Office PowerPoint. I think all of you also have a knowledge how we can open. You have to click on that start button and then go on all programs. In that all programs, click on that Microsoft Office, okay, and then select the Microsoft Office PowerPoint 2010 or 7, whatever is that, okay. So that already opened. Which type of effect? First you open the slide which you want to apply the transition effect. Now click on the transitions tab. Click on the transitions tab. Where is the transition tab? Look, transitions to this slide. Okay, there's a transitions. Various types of transitions are there. Which look. If you want to see more, then you have to click on that. Look, various types of transitions are there. Which type of you want? Okay, which type of transition effect you want, then you have to select it. If you want to like this, then click. Okay. And in that second slide, if you want any other transition, then you have to click. Which type of transition effect you want, then you have to easily select it. Okay, apply to all, whatever is that. And now next, applying sound to a transition. The sound effect added with the visual effect can enhance the overall transition effect. The steps for this are given below. Open the transition tabs. In the timing group, click on the sound drop down arrow. From the list that appears, select a required sound effect. The sound effect will be applied. Varying transition speed, how you want to varying transition speed, that is slow or fast. The duration field in the timing group allows us to set a duration of the transition effect. When we set a greater value, the length of the transition effect increases. That is, we can see the transition effect for a longer time. The reverse occurs when we decrease the duration value. We can follow these steps to set a duration for the transition effects applied to the slides in our presentation. Open the transition tab and go out a duration field. Increase or decrease the duration by clicking on the up or down arrows. The transition duration will change. Click on apply to all button to apply a transition effect to all slides of your presentation. So how we can change the speed and how we can add sounds. So I will show you. First you, I think all of you also how we can apply a transition. So first you select the slide, and from the transition to this slide you have to select which type of transition you want. If you want to this type of transition, then you have to select it. Okay, easily you have to select it. Now if you want to add sound, then how you can add? Here is a transition sound. This is no sound. If you want to add sound, then you have to click here, and there are various types of sounds are there. Okay students, which sound you want, then you have to hammer, whatever is that. In this, if you want to add any sound, then you have to select that slide, select that second slide, and go on a transition sound and apply the sound. Okay, in that third slide, if you want to add sound, then you have to click on that and okay, apply the sound easily. You have to apply the sounds. and if you want to transition speeds, how we can transition speeds, then you have to click on that. Look here is also a speed. Click on the transition speed, that is slow, medium, fast, whatever is that, okay? And if you want to manage transition speed by yourself, then you have to click, and automatically after you have to click and go on that slides, okay? Seconds is there, okay? That is easily you have to apply. And if you want to apply to all, then you have to click on that apply to all, that all will apply to all. Now I will show you how we can see this. And next topic is also that advancing the slides. We can advance from one slide to others by clicking with the mouse or automatically after waiting for a certain interval. The steps to set how you want the slides to advance in your presentation are as follows. Select a slide with the transition effect applied. To advance the slide manually, enable on the mouse click option. Or to advance the slide automatically after any interval, select the enable the after checkbox and set the time. The desired advance effect will be applied. Select apply to all button to apply the same method to all the slides of a presentation. I already show you advance slide. If you want to apply the slides after without mouse clicking, after a some time interval the slides automatically occurs, okay? Then you have to apply the advance slides automatically after I have selected that 12 seconds, okay? If this apply this, if you want that after 12 seconds, and I will click on that apply to all, that all will be selected. And how will show you slideshow tab options. Slideshow tab options. Once we prepare the presentation, we should like to show it to our audience in the form of a slideshow. PowerPoint offers us a number of options in the slideshow tab to present the slide show effectively. This is the slideshow tab. In this, various types of options are there. Options in the slideshow tab group help us to start a slideshow in different views, from beginning, from current slide, broadcast slideshow, custom slideshow, setup slideshow, hide slideshow, rehearse timings. So how I will show you. This is the slideshow, and now look, this is the from beginning button starts the slideshow from the first slide, from current slide starts the slideshow from the current slide, broadcast slideshow, custom slideshow, this is the custom slideshow, helps to show only selected slides from the presentation, okay? Click here. I will show you. I am clicking from that beginning. Now look, this will be selected. This will be selected. Okay. Every time I am applying the same. Okay. And then the setup slideshow, hide slideshow, and rehearse timing. Okay. If you want to hide any slide from that presentation, then you have to click on that hide slideshow button. If you want to set up slideshow, then you have to click on that. Now I will show you hide slide. There is a 6 slides, okay? And now if I want to hide that 4th slide, then click, and then click on that hide slide, okay? And now we start from beginning. This is the first slide, second, third, now this is the 5th and 6th, okay? Now look, that 4th is gone, okay, because we have hide that 4th slide. Then how we can unhide, then you have to click here, and then again you have to click on that hide, it will be unhide. Now all that 6 slides will be shown in the slideshow option, okay? Keyboard shortcuts for managing a slideshow: to go to next slide, space bar; to go to back to the previous slide, you have to press the backspace key; go to a particular slide number, which number, 1, 2, 3, plus enter, okay? And black screen off while talking to this audience, B, press B again to come back to the normal screen; white screen off, W, press W; stop the automatic slideshow, press yes, okay? And now rehearsing the slideshow. How we can rehearsing Rehearsing the slideshow. Rehearsing timings is a useful feature that helps us to practice presenting the slideshow. Using this feature, we can save the most appropriate timings needed to go through each slide and animation in the presentation during a slideshow. These timings can then be used to run the slideshow automatically for the audience. The steps to set these are as follows. Select a slideshow tab and locate the setup group. Click on the rehearse timing commands. You will be taken a full screen view of your presentation. Practice presenting your slideshow. When you are ready to move to the next slide, click on the next button on the recording toolbar in the top left corner. When you have reached at the end of the show, press the escape key to end your slideshow. A dialog box will appear with the total time of your presentation. If you are satisfied with your timings, click yes. As do it again, the slides of your presentation will be displayed in the slide shorter view. You can test run the show to check the timings by clicking on the slideshow button, or returns to the normal view by clicking on the normal view button. So how we can rehearse, and this is type of a rehearsal, how we present our presentation in front of anyone, and what is the timing for the first slide and what is the timing of second slide, how many times that slide appear on the screen, and after this the second slide came on which time. So all that time of timings you have to practice it, okay? So this rehearsal timing is the practicing of presenting the slideshow. So I will show you. You have to click on that slideshow, and then there is a setup slideshow, and then there is a rehearse timing, okay? Click on that here, and then look here, there is timing is going on. That is, if you want to start anything to the audience, then you have to start talking and the timing is going on. HIMS, this is my presentation from Rusty Division, whatever is written here you have to tell, and then timing is gone. This is the first, okay? The first slide times if appear, then you have to click now. This is the second, this is the total timing, and this is the timing of second slide that will be appear. Then you have to show whatever what you want to explain about this, then you have to explain in detail, okay? And this is the time after this, if you want, then you have to click again. Look here, this is the third, this is the total time, and this is the rehearsal timing of slide 3, okay? If you are explaining about this and timing is going on, now that is the fourth slide. Okay, this is the total time and this is the time of the fourth slide. Explanation of the fourth slide. Okay, and now if you want to click on yes, then you have to click on yes. And total slide shorter, the first slide is a 22 seconds, this is 21, this is 15 seconds, this is 17, 5 seconds and 2 seconds. Okay students, that is the total rehearse timing. Okay, and printing the presentation, so that is very easy. Click on that file tab and select the print option. The print backstage appears. Under the print section, copies, number of copies you have to enter, and you have to click the printer. Click on that file tab, and then there is a print option. Then you have to click on that print section, copies and whatever is that. Then here you have to all slides, current slides, selection, whatever, number of copies. Okay. If you want to third down, second down arrow, whatever is that, and then you have to click on that. Okay. And if you want to print only current slide, then you have to click here. If you want to all slides, then click and click on that. Okay. Prints what slides, headouts, notes, page, outline. I want to print only slides. Okay. Grayscale, colorful. If you want, then you have to select it. Okay. And then you have to click on that okay button. Okay, students, that is explanation is over. Thank you. Have a nice day.